The time card management feature lets users track the time they work on timesheets and create time cards to report it. It also lets managers review and approve the time cards. First, let's look at the default timesheet policies under Project Administration Settings. We're logged in as ITPPS admin role. You can create many time policies to support your organization's diverse time management workflow processes, even for individual users, including how time cards are generated, approved, and routed. You can also check the project state of each time card, which tracks time card activity. Let's check the project preferences to see what level of time reporting is allowed. We'll choose Project and Project Tasks. Let's add an employee to the new project task. Great! Joe is all set to enter the time he works. Now we're logged in as Joe. Let's record time for the task we're assigned to. To start, we navigate to the timesheet portal. It opens in a new browser tab. In the project task, we'll add 4 hours for each day of the work week. And in the other tab, we'll add the 1 hour team meeting from Tuesday. We'll double check the time we entered before we submit the timesheet. Once we submit, it'll be locked. Everything looks good, so we submit the timesheet for approval. Going forward, it may be easier to copy a previous week's timesheet and edit it for the current week. Now we're logged in as the project manager, and we need to approve Joe's time card. We'll find Joe's time cards, choose the one for the current period, and approve. Finally, let's see how the approved time card is reflected in the project. The state of the time card is processed, and an expense line was automatically created from the time card. We can see the amount of the expense. The state of the expense is pending until someone in finance approves it. For more information, see our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.